Hey guys, it's Googly again with another ROM review, and this time I've got the Viper OS version 6.6 for the OnePlus 3, so stay tuned for that. Let's get to the ROM now. First of all, what you see here is the Viper OS. Now, if you are familiar with Viper, it's a ROM by a Brazilian team of developers, which is really great. I'm still using Viper OS on my Zenfone 5. It's one of the best ROMs available. Still, I'm using Nougat on that. I'm really happy with it. This is on Pi and it has a lot of extra features. So let's get started with that. First of all, what you would see here is that, of course, the ambient display, pickup sensor, hand wave, and all that is working. Works really well. Let's go to the About phone page. Before that, this is the launcher, which is great. It is using a quick step launcher, which has the gestures and all that. I'm really happy with that. Let's go to the About phone page. In the About phone page, you can see that it is on Android 9.0, of course. July security patches. This ROM was released on 12th July, and I have been using it ever since, and pretty happy with it. Viper OS version is 6.6. Now, this is an unofficial version made by the same developer who made the AEX and a bunch of other ROMs. There is a possibility that this may not be maintained. If you are interested in this one, do go to the forum and support. Do let developer or the maintainer know that this is something which people want. Apart from that, SNSS is enforcing if you are interested in that. Viper OS, I have to say, Viper ROMs have been a really good daily driver for most of the part I have used it. It is really cool. It has a great set of features which will work with most other people. So I'm really happy with that. Before that, I do not have my SIM cards inserted on this device right now because I'm using it for some other device testing, but I say that everything is working. VLT works. I have used this and did not have any issues with it. Wi-Fi works, DNS works, and all that is working really well. Now let's get to the features without much further waiting. All the extra features are inside the Venom options, and as you can see, it's a very unique experience, something like AOKP panel settings. The first option is status bar option. The quick settings options are available where you have columns and rows. You can customize that. This is pretty interesting. All of these are the icons available, all the tiles which are available, which is basic stuff. You do have data saver, you have caffeine, you have all of these options which are really cool. I would say it's a basic options available. I'm really happy with it. One thing which I do understand or do like a lot is that there is a data switcher icon here. If you're coming from WatchOS, that would be a really good feature. Brightness and location can be enabled. Auto brightness and brightness control icons or options can be enabled from here, which does work really well. Clock options are available. You do have options for clock position, which is cool. AM PM indicator and also show seconds can be enabled if you want that. Battery icon styles are available. You have a lot of options here. No quiz style though. Battery percentage can be inside the icon, outside the icon. A lot of options are available for that. Carrier label options can be enabled or disabled. Carrier label settings are available from here. From last lock screen only, status bar every time, all that. Network traffic indicator is available. You can have it enabled in upload, download, all of that. Auto hide is available, but there is no threshold section for it. Only when it is zero, it is hidden. The traffic measurement can be enabled or disabled, which does work really well. The miscellaneous option, you do have system icons. That is the status bar icon can be customized, whatever appears, whatever you don't want. VipOS logo can be enabled on the status bar if you are someone who wants that, if you're vain like that. Tap to sleep on the status bar is also available, which is pretty interesting. Roam indicator icon is available. VLT icon can be enabled or disabled if you want to use that. 4G LTE options are available, and also corner settings are available if you want to have a rounded corner or if you want to have extra padding settings. You can even enable that. The recent option, you do have recent style. You can customize between the quick step, which is available here, which works really well. I'm really happy with it. Or the AOSP style with the panel solve option, which does work out. If you select the AOSP style, you do have the option for enabling the clear button, and also the miscellaneous bar, memory bar can be enabled from there also. The lock-in option, lock-in security options are available. You can enable automatic face unlock if you are someone who uses Google face unlock feature. Fingerprint authentication vibration is available if you want the feedback. In the miscellaneous option, temperature unit for the Zen settings are available. You can customize that. Ambient display options or ambient music ticker is available. Hide status bar on the last screen is available, and also lock screen charging info can be enabled if you want to have that. The system options, color management is available. One of the better implementation of UI settings. You do have the device themes options are available. You do have perfect dark, you have a plum style setting, which is really cool. Accent colors are also available, which is really really good. You do have options for a lot of them. Quick setting icons can be customized to whatever you want from one of these options. Switch styles also can be available, and this is really cool. A lot of other ones also have this option, but it doesn't have a visual indicator for it, which I really like. I really like the material design too. You can also have the OnePlus style or material design one. Clock style can also be customized, which is really nice. So you do have options for customizing that. It does work really well. I'm really happy with how it turns out. In the fun picker, you do have customization for extra funds. Not a whole lot of funds, but a few of my favorite are there. Anaheim is there. Samsung One is available. A lot of extra good funds are available to pick from. The button option, you do have customization for the backlight, which does work really well. Personally, I don't really care too much about changing the settings on it. Power button long press for torch is available with automatic turn off, which is really cool. Power button to end the call is available, which I have been finding used for more frequently with my OnePlus 6T. Navigation bar can be enabled if you want to use that. Personally, if you don't want to use it, it just stays disabled. I mean, on a OnePlus 3, I would much prefer to have the screen not tainted with that. Home button options are available, long press action, and also double tap action can be customized. It's the line style options available. Recent bar options are also available for short press and long press options. Volume button controls are available with the control playback via long pressing the volume buttons, and also keyboard cursor control is available. These are the two things which I look forward to in a custom ROM. In the extras option, you do have options for customizing the alert slider. Alert slider is working, you do have options for it, and also swap button is available. Many other ROMs which I tried from this developer, or this maintainer I should say, doesn't have this option as just one click. I'm happy that it is here. Navigation gestures are available if you are someone who wants to use it. Personally, on the OnePlus 3, it doesn't really make much of a sense. Battery charge light can be customized, you do have options for it. You can also customize the brightness levels of it, which is interesting. How many options are available? You can enable the advanced restart button here and also disable when it is locked. And we have the about phone page. In the about phone page, you have the founder and all that. You can just read about them, who are these people. You can just get to know these guys, go to their Telegram page, go to their GitHub and check for their code and all that. Now, apart from the banner options, there are a few options in the display option. It does have live display, it does have color profile. Dynamic color profile is one of my favorite things. I really wish this option is available with other ROMs also. Apart from that, ambient display options are available. You can enable pickup, hand wave and pocket mode, as I've already demonstrated this. It works really well. You can disable that if you don't want that. Double tap to sleep is available, double tap to wake is available. Now, some which I do want to mention, I am on an encrypted device, so encryption works decently well, didn't have any issues with it. Now, system options, it does have the gesture options where you have double tap on the power button for them to camera. Touchscreen gestures are available. To be extremely honest, most of these options doesn't work all the time. Yes, it is working now, but I have seen that it's not entirely reliable. I just turned these off because I've grown out of it. So guys, there you have it. That is the features available with this ROM, which is a lot of features actually. It does work really well for the feature department. I'm really happy with it. It doesn't bog you down with a lot of features. Lately, I've been using Havoc on all my ROMs now, and to be extremely honest, a lot of features I'm starting to find a little overwhelming because, well, there are a lot of things which I don't use on it. I like the features available in this one. It's cool. Now, let's talk about the performance. The performance on this ROM is pretty decent. I'm getting about 160,000, which is normal for this ROM. I'm happy with it. Not going to smash any records or anything, but I'm happy with whatever I'm getting with this one. I do want to mention that I did try PUBG on this one. It's not bad. It's not as bad as what I anticipated or what I expected. I was getting almost 25 to 27 FPS constantly, even in heavily used or heavily available sections, which is pretty good. I like it. Performance wise, it's pretty good. Now let's get to the battery life. The battery life is actually pretty good, and I was actually using it with SIM card and as my daily driver. The battery life was somewhere around 15 to 16% of active, which is acceptable. I can accept that. And about 1.3 to 1.6 percentage. Yes, it is quite a bit different depending on the day's usage, but again, 1.3 to 1.6 percentage of idle drain, which is also something I can still get behind because it works decently well. No issues for the most part. It's been working really well for me. Again, it does have aggressive battery options. You want to get a little bit more idle battery drain, and also battery profiles are available. Now, the stability of the ROM. The stability of the ROM is also pretty good. I didn't have any crashes when I was using this. I was pretty happy with it. I had no complaints about this ROM. That is not something that you get with a lot of ROMs nowadays. I'm not saying that other ROMs are flawed, but I am saying that having no complaints about a ROM is kind of rare. Now, the camera. It comes with snap camera with decent enough features, which works really well. I've been happy with it. It takes decent photographs. It does have modes. It does have a night mode, which is interesting if you want to use it. It does have Google camera available for the device. It works decently well. Now, the the aesthetics of the ROM. The aesthetics of the ROM is also pretty good. As I've already said, it does have a pretty unique take on the aesthetics. Unique in the sense that the selection menus are better, in my opinion, than other ROMs which are representative. Like many ROMs, you can't see what you are selecting. With Style, you cannot see what you're selecting until you make the selection. May not be a big deal for many people, but I mean, it's just one of those things, right? It is the aesthetic department, so I mean, the way it is presented is also interesting. It should be interesting, so I find this very interesting. Now, the overall experience of the ROM. As I've said, I love this ROM. I mean, Viper OS or Viper ROM or Field of Venom, whatever you want to call this. It's a very good daily driver. I like it a lot. Works really well as a daily driver, and I don't really need to change to a different ROM, honestly. The stock kernel is also pretty good at almost everything, so I'm really happy with it. It just works really well. It also comes with a recorder for screen recording and sound recording, which does work really well. I'm really huge fan of Lineage style screen recorder because it does have settings for it. It also comes with Wii wallpapers, so yeah, you can select, you can check out different wallpapers with the Viper branding on it. The community behind Viper ROM is pretty big. There is a huge push for it. I'm really happy with that. Let me show you guys the boot animation, which is pretty cool. There is a shutdown animation also, if in case you didn't notice. So there you have it, guys. That is the boot animation for Viper OS, which is, I mean, one of the slickest boot animation I have seen. Because I mean, there are boot animation which just doesn't have any imagination into it. This is pretty good. I mean, this is just great. Feel the venom in your wings. So guys, there you have it. That is the Viper OS for the OnePlus 3, and it is one of the best ROMs available for the OnePlus 3. Fairly minimal, but still with enough features to keep you entertained for a long time to come. So I'm really happy with it. I guess that much is it about the ROMs. And hope you guys liked the video. Please share, subscribe, and like the video if you found it useful. See you guys next time. Bye.